Hello guys, and welcome to Till Vacuum Do Us Part. We're gonna go ahead and get straight into today's video. It's a relaxing clean with me. I needed to get some cleaning done on the inside and outside of this house, so we're gonna go ahead and start on the outside first. So you're gonna just see me grab all my supplies, and then I'm gonna head on out to the back patio. So if you're new here, my last video was my modern farmhouse back porch makeover. So if you missed that, definitely go back and check it out. I also have a dining room makeover. You guys have really been enjoying these videos, and I've had so much fun making them for you, but it is a mess out here because we're basically living out here. So I wanted to go ahead and get it nice and clean. So we're going to just start off by cleaning off the table because I've had my nieces in town and they've been painting and crafting and glue. So I just needed to make sure everything was nice and clean. If you're not following me over on Instagram, definitely click on those links down below in my description box. I'm over there daily posting on that, so I'm just more active, so you'll definitely see and hear me more over there, so don't forget to follow me. As much as we are living out here and loving being on the patio, some days it's just too hot and so we go inside, but I love to have like my blinds and curtains open so we can still see the space. But these windows have been so dirty just with like bugs and dirt and a little bit of pollen. We don't get pollen like some of you, but just a little bit. So I wanted to go ahead and wipe them down. I'm just using my Jaws glass cleaner and then my eCloth polishing rag. You'll never have a streak or lint again if you use these two together. They're like by far my favorite products. I have links down below in my description box as well as coupon codes, so definitely check those out if you're needing some. I decided why I had that glass cleaner out. I was gonna go ahead and work on these clear chairs. They really do stay really clean. Like, I was impressed with them. I've had them indoors before too, but like I mentioned earlier, my nieces and my daughter were just out here crafting, so I felt like they had tape and glitter and glue and paint all on these chairs, and they all cleaned off so well on all of these. I'll try to remember to link these down below. If not, definitely check out this last video. I linked everything that you see up here on this patio, and I also show tutorials on how we did it. So if you're wanting to redo your back patio or you're needing like kid-friendly chairs, those are even great for the inside. I've been super impressed with them, how well they're holding up and how well they clean. But now I'm just gonna go ahead and sweep my back patio. We've had so many people in and out. I just try to keep that as clean as possible so a lot of dirt's not coming inside. So I did end up moving this rug out here to the patio. I know when I showed you guys in my last video, it wasn't there yet, but I kind of just like a rug underneath the table. I don't know what it is. I feel like it softens the space. I don't know how long it's going to last. It's lasting right now because there's no rain in the forecast. That's going to be completely different when the boys get muddy and run up and down. So if they run all over it, it may not last. I don't mind cleaning it. We have our shampooer, so it'll just be how bad it gets and how much they're on it. But I thought I would definitely just try it out. Some of you guys mentioned to put it on the front porch with a sectional, but then it's just getting a little too homey, I think, a little bit too living room out on the front porch. So I definitely wanted just to try it out here, and I really loved having it. The kids can sit on the ground and do stuff, and it's just a soft place to land. So far it's working out, but we'll see how long that lasts. In every color, resting your head in my arms, you sing.
Sorrows in the summer city, you never feel alone as long as you're with me.
Now I'm going to go ahead and work on vacuuming the rug. I do think this is something I'm going to have to do all the time, but if you guys know me, I vacuum all the time anyways, and I'm out here all the time, so I just don't mind doing it while Savannah's swimming just to make sure it's nice and fresh. I know a lot of you guys see some of the way I decorate with like the whites or the rugs outside, and you're just like, no, 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 it's going to get too dirty. I don't mind cleaning. I just don't. I enjoy it. It keeps me busy. I'm not one to like sit down and relax. I try to sit down and tan my legs for like 10 minutes of a time, and then I just get bored even if like I'm answering comments. I just like to be up moving, so I don't mind if it's a little bit of work. That's also why we painted our house white. Some of you guys were like, no, you're gonna have to clean it. That's okay. We don't mind cleaning. We don't mind putting some work in. Like I said, we're just busy bees, so we really just enjoy the look of the house and we don't mind maintaining it. So we're super happy with this patio, and I'm super happy with the rug right now. I'm just kind of crossing my fingers that the boys don't destroy it. Get rid of all your sorrows. I always get asked how I spot clean my white rugs, and I just like to use soapy hot water. So I just get an old rag and I use really hot water, and then I pour some liquid dish soap on it. We had a s'mores incident on my rug this weekend, which is totally okay. It actually has been there for like 3 days. I keep forgetting to clean it, and so I wasn't sure if it was gonna come out, but after just a few minutes of working on it, it came right up. I feel like rugs really do hold up better than you think, even if they're white. I do always get asked for a link on this rug. It's from Ross, and I can't link Ross, and I cannot find this rug anywhere else. But every time I go into Ross, they always have it, or it comes back into stock. So just check your local Ross. If I ever find it, I'll definitely let you guys know where I can link it. But currently, I cannot find it anywhere. Now I'm gonna head back inside because it is super hot here. I was even filming this in the morning before it got too hot, but I still got a little sweaty outside. So I'm just gonna clean up some of the products that I was using outside, and then we'll start working on this kitchen. Now before I start cleaning my kitchen and taking all the dishes out and putting them away, I wanted to go ahead and wash my hands. I know a lot of times we as influencers don't show you that we wash our hands because normally we do it off camera, but I wanted to show you guys we do wash our hands if we go from like cleaning outside on the ground into cleaning our kitchen and putting away clean dishes, but I know we don't always show that, so I know you guys appreciate it when we do. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and work on unloading my dishwasher. I seem like I'm doing that every single day since we've been home and just stuck inside a lot. I feel like I run it every single day, and I feel like smaller loads just are more manageable versus going 2 days and it just being so full and not everything fitting and having to hand wash it. So I definitely want to make sure it's a full load, but I don't want it to be like overflowing. We've had a lot of treats in the house just since my nieces were in town and my parents have been over a lot helping with them. And so we've had all these cookies and muffins. And so I was trying to figure out how I was going to pare them down or put them away. I don't like the look of them just stacked up. And I feel like the more I can see them, I'm just going to eat them nonstop versus just like tucking them away. So I decided to go ahead and just put them in Ziploc bags. I feel like these boxes, they just go bad quickly, and that just gives me another reason to eat them all at once, because I'm like, they're gonna go bad. So I went ahead and stuck them in Ziploc bags, and I tucked them in my island just so I don't think about it nonstop. I did recently pick up these sugar-free like chocolate chip cookies, and the girls loved them. I had no idea they were sugar-free, but the girls didn't even notice. I'm not saying they're super healthy, but it was nice that they just weren't like covered in sugar and chocolate. So definitely check those out at your Walmart if you're interested in those, but Savannah loved them. But now I'm gonna go ahead and wipe down my countertops just from all the crumbs, and I just love the smell too. I love wiping down my countertops so they're shiny and my kitchen smells clean, so I'm gonna work on that right now. Now I'm going to go ahead and switch out my products so I can go wipe down my dining room table. We've been eating breakfast and lunch there, so I just want to make sure it's nice and clean. A lot of you guys have been buying this table since I shared it in my dining room makeover video, so I just wanted to share with you how I was cleaning it. I've kind of used all different products just like I did on my last table. I like to use the Jaws wood cleaner. I also like to use the Thieves cleaner. I've even used just like a water, you know, like a paper towel with water on it, wiped it down. It seems to clean up really nicely so far, so I'm super happy with it. But I just wanted to share that just in case you guys were curious. As you can see, I'm just working on vacuuming the floors. I just like for them to stay as clean as possible, and I just feel like it doesn't take much time with these cordless vacuums, and then my house feels clean for the rest of the day. So I'm just gonna go ahead and vacuum my wood floors and my rugs right in here, and then we'll be moving on to the next space. I'm out of reasons, I'm out of rhyme, but I'll only tell you that I'm out of time. I'm sick of love songs. I also wanted to remind you to do not click off this video yet. At the end of this video, I'm going to be sharing with you how much we raised in last Wednesday's video. I'm so excited to share that amount with you. So definitely don't click off yet, and don't speed this video up. Go ahead and finish watching it, and then I'll share that total with you at the very end. Show me your love like it is, and open my heart like you're fearless. Steal all the gold you can get, show me your love, leave me breathless, breathless. So I had been noticing these shelves had gotten so dusty lately. I didn't realize how much these would hold dust, but I love having my shoes on display here in my beauty room. These are just four different cube shelves I bought from Walmart, and I just stacked them on top of each other and next to each other. I don't know, I just feel like it's the perfect way to display your shoes if you're looking for something like that, and it's super affordable. So I'll try to put that link down below my description box if you're needing something like this, but you're just going to kind of see me go from one thing to the next, and I'll even show you my rag at the very end because it was just so dusty. I was shocked because I don't feel like this room gets very dirty, but apparently it does get very dusty.
You're fearless. Steal all the gold you can get, you can get. Show me your love.
Okay, and here's what my rag looks like. I just cannot believe how dusty it was. I feel like I just did this cleaning on a video not too long ago. I don't know, maybe time is flying by. But now I'm gonna head into my laundry room. This has definitely been my catch-all lately, and this is already just a really narrow space. So I'm going to go ahead and work on switching out the laundry and all the loads. You can tell it's a lot of Savannah stuff. Our nieces were in town, so we just had a lot of like girl stuff going on. And then after I get the load going, I'm going to tidy up this room as well. I don't know what it was. I'll show you like a full view of it before I start cleaning it. But there was just stuff all over the floor. I feel like Georgia's stuff's in here and then a lot of our laundry's in here. I don't know. I've just felt super cramped in this room lately. You. I would watch the days go by, wasted in blue. I was out of use. Now every day, every night, every moment with you, I'm walking on air. And every day. Okay, so here is what it looks like on the ground. That is George's blanket. That used to be my favorite blanket until George chewed a hole through it. That was when he was still like a younger puppy, and so I just gave it to him. But at least when he's laying on it, it matches my house. But I have my dirty cleaning rags. I had the broom. I don't know. There was just stuff. I feel like when we got busy with family in town, I just kept throwing stuff in here and shutting the door, and it shows. So I'm just gonna go ahead and work on getting this nice and clean. I really want to work on this space soon. It's just a small little area, but I don't know. I feel like it's just so hodgepodge. It's like the items that I'm not using, I kind of throw in this space just so it's not blank, but I definitely need to do something with it. It looks super farmhouse right there, and I want to add some glam to this room. And I need to clean it up. Like I said, it's just been my catch-all. I've been throwing my rags in here, and my dirty rags are supposed to be in that basket that ended up just like a catch-all basket. So I'm going to clean that out, put the dirty rags back in it, and I do need to just do like a laundry makeover one day. Obviously, I can't do a ton in here, and that's why I keep putting it off, but I feel like I can make just a few tweaks to it just to make it a little bit nicer. So hopefully that video will come up soon once I kind of get back out shopping and figuring out what I want to do with the space. Okay, now I'm gonna head into our master bedroom. This is another space that I wanna work on soon. I feel like that list just keeps growing. But I feel like as I perfect other areas, I walk into other rooms of the house and I'm like, ah, this is just like not where it needs to be yet. I feel like we can move it up a level. And these rooms are just holding me back because I'm not sure how much I want to spend and how much I want to do or all the pieces I want in it. But I'm definitely going to start narrowing it down. So like I said, I need to do that laundry room makeover. I need to do a master bedroom makeover. I kind of work on some of our bathrooms. So none of them need this like huge remodel. I just feel like I need to redecorate them a little bit so they'll be like, you know, budget friendly videos. So let me know if you want to see something like that in the future. I wanna get to your clothes, gotta get it right now. I wanna push all the limits with you right now. So watch your feelings, the city's screaming, we're not coming home tonight. We're living quick in the world, gotta get it right now. People talk and tell what you wanna hear now. So this is one of my most dreaded spaces right now. Chase needs a computer and desk to work from, and so do I. And we can't work from one just because we need to work sometimes at the same time. And I use an Apple computer to edit, and he needs just like a Windows PC for some of the stuff we do. And I have no idea where to put that desk right now, but we really need our dresser back in here so we have more of a TV stand. I don't know. There's so much stuff going on in this room that's going on wrong that I'm gonna figure it out one day, but I haven't yet. So definitely videos coming soon if you wanna see them, but I'm gonna just go ahead and vacuum the floors and try not to think about this room. That we should be together. It's heavy weather, we're heading for tonight. You better take what you can, cause the time is right now. Okay, now the last thing I'm gonna work on is folding Savannah's laundry. Normally I have her do her own laundry, but I feel like this was really hodgepodged, and I also knew my nieces had forgot a few items, so I wanted to pull out their items so I could get them shipped back to them to Texas. And then I had some other items in here that was mine, so I didn't want her to have to worry about sorting all of that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it for her, and then once everything's folded, I'll just put it on her bed and she can put it away. I try not to touch her drawers or Chase's. I feel like we all have our own system, and when I do it my way, they can't find what they need. So I finally just given up control and let them have their own space. And if they put it away and I don't have to see it, then I don't care. But if I have to open the drawer, I'm just like, oh my goodness, let's reorganize all of this. But I get to keep my space the way I like it, and they get to keep theirs, and so it works really well. Plus I don't have to do their laundry anymore because they fold it and put away, so it's definitely been a win-win. Okay, you guys are doing awesome. You've almost made it to the very end of this video. I'm about to be sharing with you how much we raised and how much we were able to donate as a community together. So hang tight just a few more seconds and I'll be sharing that with you. Everything is wrong. You feel like it's your fault. Just remember, I will be there for you, baby. So to everybody that watched ads, watched them multiple times, watched this video over and over, definitely give yourself a pat on the back. As a community, you guys raised $395.58, so I'm so impressed with you guys. If I were to match that, it would be $797.16, but I decided to go ahead and kind of round up, and I made a $900 donation in our name. So thank you guys so much for just being a part of that. I'm going to go ahead and show you a few clips so you can see that I actually made that donation, and you can see Ashley Till Vacuum right there. It took every single one of us to do that, so thank you so much. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.